So starting off with our general map here for the proposed alternate route. You know, about June 27th, the flow, the lava flows around here someplace. As of today, it's I think it's around here. So the projection is that it's either going at the right where Malama Market is, or it could go 3/4 of a mile south, which would take it through the whole village. So from June 27th, we narrowed down 5 scenarios to basically 2 scenarios. One is if Highway 130 is cut here, which would be north of Malama Market or through Pahoa Town. Then the question would be, what would happen after it passes Highway 130? It could go all the way to the beach, to the coast, or it could cut through the village, come down through here, possibly cut Kahakai and go down to the coast. So that's the scenarios that we're working with right now, and develop, you know, alternate routes, and this would be alternate routes in different stages. Depends on what happens 5 days from now, 10 days from now, 12 days from now, and 20 days from now. So let me go back one. Okay, this is what the data that we're working with, besides the potential locations of the cut with the Highway 130. This is a traffic cut that was done in 2012. And basically what it shows is that right around here, after Kahakai, you're about 11,300 vehicles per day. Between here, it's dropped down to about 7,800 vehicles per day. So this is the major, the primary route, and this is the road along railroads. This is what it looks like as of today, in fact. We have broken through between railroad has broken through between Hawaiian Beaches, Hawaiian Shores, and also Hawaiian Paradise Point. This is another section. You see the heavy equipment working. This is as of September 14th, so this was a couple days ago. This is in railroad from Hawaiian Beaches going towards Hawaiian Paradise Point. Yeah, more pictures of the road in progress. That's that area. Let's see, what does it look like on the Hawaiian Shore side of the railroad or on the south side? This is what it looks like looking at it from Kahakai looking south, breaking through. Fortunately, we see a lot of loose material here. So it's been a matter of loose material and solid rock, blue rock that we've been working with. That's that area here. Okay, this is the Bishop Estate property of Kamehameha Schools. It runs through papaya fields. That is the connector road which will take us from Mapu all the way to Nanavali. This is the Nanavali end, and this is the takeoff to Kahakai. What it looks like. This is, of course, the 14th of September. Again, we're talking about 2 primary routes. This will be the primary route. This is what we call the railroad connection with the 2 lanes, compacted gravel. And the primary route, if the Highway 130 is cut here, would be through Nanavali on Pihau, down to the Kamehameha Schools property, picking up railroad, crossing Hawaiian Shores, Hawaiian Beaches, coming up to Maku, and Maku would be the primary route to get to 130. Now, if the road is, highway is cut at the village, but not necessarily, but not yet hitting the bypass, then the route would be from Tunana Valley to Kamehameha Schools, along railroad, and up Kahaka, and then along 130 back to Hilo. This is the beach road. Basically, it's a 10-foot county right-of-way road. This is what it looks like as of yesterday. What we're trying to do is there are a number of archaeological features, walls, enclosures. There are also EV or burials. So basically, we're trying to stay away from affecting any of the key archaeological features.